Scusate, scusate.
I've never seen anything like this.
Call 911.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. We take a look back this week at the worst in pile of all year.
And what better way to start our annual repugnant pile of show than by talking to you about the first horrible repugnant pile of for 2012. The Devil Inside.
Come on, Isabella, you know the words.
The itsy bitsy spider went up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun.
Isabella, don't listen to it.
The Devil Inside is one of the most mind-numbingly stupid piles of I have ever seen, and without a doubt, going to be one of the worst movies of 2012. Sadly, for many people, this will be the first movie they see all year, and it's bad enough that it might prevent them from going to the movies for the rest of the year. Here we have another found footage mockumentary, another god exorcism movie, and another intelligence-insulting horror film all wrapped into one feces-stained package. The plot here, if you can even call it that, is that a woman named Maria Rossi murdered three exorcists in 1989. So of course she was found insane and sent to Rome for treatment because the Vatican is there? What the f- Then, 20 years later, her daughter decides that she wants to fly to Rome to find out the truth and make a movie about exorcisms. What the f***? When she gets there, she meets some priests who perform exorcisms, and after sitting in on one like a f***ing ride along for tourists, they decide they can get the doctor in charge of her mother at the mental institution to let them put her in a room, unsupervised, with priests, tied down for 2 hours, and while they have this wonderful visitation, right, they will perform an exorcism on her. What the f***? That's all I'm going to tell you about the plot, other than to say that after this point, the film gets so stupid that you may want to tear your eyes out or become possessed by a demon, because it would certainly be more enjoyable than sitting through this garbage. Half a star for The Devil Inside.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen, that movie was so bad that it got a lower rating than any movie I watched in all of 2011. But that's okay. That doesn't mean that we can't enjoy all of the crap from last year.
It's here.
That's right, my friends, the number 10 worst pile of movie of 2011 is Red Riding Hood. I actually gave this movie 2 stars when it came out, but the more I think about it, the more I can't get over how unbelievably horrible the acting was in this movie. It may have looked good, it may have sounded good, may have had some good costume designs, but oh my god, the acting in this movie was so bad, I could not stand it. It made me roll my eyes into the back of my skull, and I wanted to skull myself all night long. Seriously, that would have been more enjoyable than watching this film. And the more I think about it, it drives me so insane that it makes me sick. Especially from such a talented director. It's like she went and made Twilight, and then Catherine Hardwicke came back, and she was just the most worthless pile of you could ever possibly imagine. So number 10, Red Riding Hood.
Noah, can you get the phone?
Color of the sky.
Mom, the phone's ringing. Mom, the phone's ringing. Do you hear it?
I know it feels like we just got done hating this movie, and this is only one of 3 terrible movies that came out in the month of December. December is always the time for the best films of the year, but for some reason this year, they also decided to throw out their garbage a little early. The first of those films was The Sitter. This movie was so f***ing stupid that I couldn't even think straight watching it. This movie went along from one unbelievable sequence to the next, and there was no laughing, nothing. It just was cringe-inducing. Especially Sam Rockwell's cokehead, coke dealer, moron. God. Just thinking about how bad his character was in this film makes me want to upchuck. I'm going to try and be nice. Number 9. The Sitter.
Okay, so play me a song.
Yeah, I got a song for you.
Every year there are hundreds of movies made that are so f***ing bad that you basically don't hear about them until they show up on video. They usually have sat on a shelf for many, many years. Directors and producers can't figure out what in the world to do with the pile of junk, so they eventually give it a small theatrical release and then throw it at you. Movies like The Double, Texas Killing Fields, and my personal least favorite of last year, A Perfect Age of Rock and Roll. This movie is the most god-awful movie about a band I have ever seen in my life, and there have been some doozies. This movie is pathetically written, horribly acted, and is honestly just god-awful ugly. The only reason I even saw this thing was because the actress Taryn Manning was doing a press circuit through here, and so I had to see it first before we did an interview with her. During the interview, Taryn said that in the final scene where she cheats on her boyfriend and he catches her in the act, which everybody saw coming, the director told her that she was so amazing that he could have made a movie out of just her performance. Well, I gotta tell you, Taryn, you seem like a nice girl, but either the director is a f***ing liar or he's a f***ing idiot. Number 8. A Perfect Age of Rock and Roll.
Call 911!
Teenage girl from the North Shore. Shark attack.
Some movies, I will admit that as a film critic, I enjoy tearing apart. It's just, you know, fun. This movie, Soul Surfer, is not one of them. I was really hoping that this movie was going to be a heartfelt story, because it really is an amazing one. But they ripped this movie apart themselves by cutting it at 90 miles an hour with a million close-ups and shooting it like a Michael Bay action movie. This movie was pathetic, and I honestly don't want to harbor on it at all. Number 7, Soul Surfer. So raise your glass if you are mad, in all the right
ways, on the underdogs. We will never be happy. Well, there's going to be more celebrities here than rehab.
Ah, New Year's Eve, our second December Not to Remember event. I really don't even know what to say about this film. There are like 10 stories in it, and none of them are worth remembering whatsoever. I like a lot of the people in this film, especially Michelle Pfeiffer, who we haven't seen in a long time. But even her little story is so boring, so dry, and so unmemorable that I hardly can even recall what happened. This movie is recycled material that could have been written by anybody on any day of any week at any time. And honestly, despite the fact that they continue to throw these things out like candy, I don't know anybody that wants to see this crap. So, on behalf of the viewing public, Gary Marshall, you, make something good. Do a remake of Pretty Woman for Christ's sake. That would be more entertaining than this crap. Number 6, New Year's Eve.
Beautiful people get it better. That's just the way it is.
There's a special place up my for Beastly. This movie is a piece of that I don't ever want to see again. It ruins a classic tale by making it out to be shallow, ugly, and pathetic. After just watching the remake of Beauty and the Beast in 3D today, it makes me hate this movie even more. And this film is lucky that I wrote this list a week ago. Otherwise, it would be even lower. Number 5, Beastly.
You are a bad influence on her.
The Roommate was a sick and twisted piece of that used depression as a vehicle for a stupid thriller that was honestly insulting. Knowing quite a bit about depression and having family members who have gone through this horrible disease made this movie even more sickening and disgusting to me. I honestly wish that I could find the filmmaker that made this movie and make him experience what it's like for a depressive for one day. Then maybe he'll actually think twice about using other people's tragedies as a joke for his own personal gain. Number 4, The Roommate.
They can see us, but we can't see them.
The Darkest Hour was the very last movie that I saw in 2011, and I honestly didn't even bother reviewing it because I don't know how to describe how I felt about this film. This is a god-awful piece of crap, but I'm actually happy that I managed to make it through the first half of this movie because it's so bad that I wanted to walk out of the theater. However, once you make it to the second half, it gets so much worse, and it gets so bad that you will find yourself laughing out loud if you have any sense. Extra microwave gun. Remember that line. Extra microwave gun. Worst line of the year. Number 3, The Darkest Hour.
Hey, what's that?
It says, will you marry...
Will you marry me?
No.
Really?
It's official, my friends. Happy Madison Productions is absolutely the worst existing production company in the entire world. They just put out one pile of after another, after another, after another. I cannot remember the last good movie that Happy Madison Productions put out. Maybe it was a decade ago. And Zookeeper is the bottom of the barrel. Well, maybe. You'll have to watch the rest of the show. But either way, I mean, what a bad movie. I mean, this movie is not for kids, it's not for adults, it's not for animals, it's not for sea creatures. It's not for anybody. It's stupid, mindless, moronic crap that has no laughs in the entire hour and a half that you will have to slog through it. So do yourself a favor. Skip this sh**. Number 2. Zookeeper.
Are you going bald?
Huh?
No, you're getting fatter, and your hair doesn't realize that it needs to cover more face.
Okay.
I just can't defend Adam Sandler anymore, honestly. I mean, I like the guy. He was one of my favorite comedians when I was a kid, but I can't do it anymore. Everything that this guy makes is a pile of crap. Everything. And it's sad. I mean, I have to take that back. Funny People was actually a good movie a couple of years ago, did rain on me. So it's not everything, it's just everything that Happy Madison does, everything that his own personal production company does is such crap that there's no reason. He's so lazy. Why are you so lazy, Adam? Why are you so lazy? Every one of these films is lazy as anybody with half of a brain cell could put these things together and they would be better than this. Please, 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 Adam, I know you have another couple of movies coming out next year. Could you at least make them just a little bit better? So that maybe they end up on the bottom of my worst list. For now, 2 years in a row, buddy. Worst film of 2011, Jack and Jill.
All right, that's going to do it for our show this week. I hope you enjoyed looking back at all of the pieces of from last year. Next week, we will look at all the wonderful movies from last year.
Want more movies, reviews, and videos? Visit our website online at www.thankufw.com. And as always, we thank you for watching.